Welcome back. It's the final match of the evening on the main table here tonight, table one, and it's on the left Matthew Stevens of Wales and Mark Joyce of England. Best of seven still, and the winner will be in the last 16, which is tomorrow. And Mark Joyce, who's only recently completed a victory, and Andrew Higginson 4-1, is breaking off. This is hit a little thin, and he's hit the yellow on the way back, which is done him a favour. It looks like it's covered. Not this time, though. I think there's a gap for Mark Joyce to get through. Too many people around this table at the moment. It might filter in. We've got matches going on elsewhere which are attracting interest. Two-one Joe Swellev and Mark Selby. That's the one they're all watching. Peter Ebden, Mark King. Goodness, that could be a long match. Not yet started. Liam Highfield and Oliver Brown. They're on the last few pots. They'll let you know who wins. And it looks like Kyron Wilson is about to dismantle Alan McManus 4-0. And he's 71-0 up and 3-0 up on a break of 71. So that might be a whitewash there by the looks of things. Yes, he's on 87. So that's going to be a 4-0 to Kyron. Mark was furious that not played that very well, but if the two Reds have lined themselves up for a plant, he'd be very lucky. I don't think they are lined up. I don't think it's never going to get past those reds there. He's let Joyce straight back in.
Twenty-two. 23.
He's looking pretty good. Got in first and then he broke down because of the bad kiss that he got.
44. 51.
Still got a little bit of work to do. 67 points in it. He's only really got a pot of red mathematically, but a colour and a further red will seal the deal for the first frame.
Sixty-four.
75. It's a fine break. Really good start from Mark Joyce.
82.
89, Mark Joyce, and a very thorough and emphatic victory in frame one against Matthew Stevens. He leads by a frame to nil. Well, it'll count.
11.
We can go into the bunch here with pace. He's got a new cue these days. He had his old cue stolen. And I don't know with his old cue, whether he'd have pulled that or not, he probably would have. It's worked out badly for him. Yes, his cue was stolen over his car during the summer, earlier in the summer, and the same cue he's had for years, and it never was never returned. So here he is using a different cue, which I think by now he must have halfway got used to. I asked him about it. He said he had got used to it. King has won the opening frame against Peter Ebden, I can tell you. It's okay, he's on one to the middle. Hits it the near jaw. How did that stay out? I'm surprised.
6.
This is a very bright start. He missed a red to the middle. The difference between the two was that he got a little bit lucky when he missed, and the red cleared away from the pocket. And of course, when Matthew did, he somehow it stuck over the middle. I don't quite know how it finished there. Now, I don't know whether anything goes in there. He's looked over on the left side. This is a good effort. Deserves to be on something. Well, I don't know if he is. He may be on that left red. Don't know. Well, that's what he tried. Now, very frustrating to go in behind that red. Squeezed in. Four. played that well. Trying to miss the yellow.
10.
Just got to avoid reds in potting this. Go between the two reds, I think. A little bit more work to do here. Well, that was well done. 54, and that's enough to level this match at 1-1. Matthew Stevens won. Mark Joyce won. First blood once again to Matthew Stevens. Just letting you know we have a bit of a backlog of matches because of the Barry Pinch's George Pragnell game is still going on. So until that finishes, David Gilbert's just got to hang on. So we're a match down there.
Four.
assume that the pink goes. Well, he's short on the blue. He has got that red with the black on, but it's from further away than he would have hoped. They'd be fuming. Got the wrong side of the blue, and he's further away from the red than he would have liked. That's basically what happened there. That's okay. Cue ball's lost slightly, but not so bad. He's actually kissed that pink. He's okay on the red now.
Twenty-eight. 4.
He's still okay. He's a bit close to the cushion here. He knocks a lot of balls in, doesn't he? Well, it's been a fluent match so far, these two. Moving that red out of the way, which clears the path past the pink now. So that's a nice play. It's 2-1. Certainly will be very shortly to Mark Joyce. That's going to be a century break, by the looks of things, and a very good one at that.
86.
There are a few spectators in around this table, not that many, but they'll give them a nice clap. Most of the spectators are elsewhere. They might just, as I say, filter down. I'm just looking down on the table. There's probably about 50 people in here. Very nice. Century break. Break of 104, which means Mark Joyce leads Matthew Stevens 2-1. Elsewhere. We've got a respot, Swale and Selby. 79 points each, goodness. Don't know who's going to win it. Obviously, I'm not in a position to see out there. Looks to have gone to a respot, frame four. And until we hear the roar in the Stadthalle here in Firth, I don't suppose we'll find out. There's a bit of a smattering of applause. I wonder if it's Swale 3-1 up. We'll find out in a moment. King of frame up on Peter Ebden and 3-all George Pragnell and Barry Pinches. The winner that's got to play again tonight. Goodness, could be late. And Ian Byrne 3-0 up on Joe O'Connor and maybe on the brink of making his way through. 3-0 down this morning against Andy Hicks and beating 4-3. Apparently they've been on the black ball for over 15 minutes on table two. Goodness me, what is going on there? This is epic. That is amazing, as long as that on the final black. Tell you that Joe Swale potted that black and leads the world champion 3-1. is off again. That's good results. He's beaten Judd Trump twice in the UK Championships. The year either side of Judd winning it, actually. In 2011. Beat him in 2010 and 2012. See a couple of reds both pop there, as you could see. They're all going in the middle of the pocket, aren't they? He's looking good. Just, to be honest, doesn't really look like missing, and I'll probably put the curse on him for saying that. Thirty-six. mind he made a century in the previous frame. He's seeing the big.
61.
Well, he's almost there. He's actually mathematically there with a snooker needed, but another red will absolutely win the frame. Not sure he wanted that because he can't take a high enough value colour with the red, and if he doesn't put a colour, I suspect he'll concede anyhow. Probably got to just knock the brown in and be done with it. Yeah, as I said, he would concede if he missed a colour, and that's it. It's 3-1 to Mark Joyce, and he's playing exceptionally well. He's barely missing a ball, and he needs one more frame and he'll be back tomorrow. frame five. A very impressive display thus far from Mark Joyce. We missed that by a mile. Sometimes now, the way I see of Matthew here, I wonder if he is used to this cue. Some of the long pots, he's kind of pushing straight onto them. If he's not entirely happy. I think it was going to take a rest shot for him to miss. He hadn't been missing anything else. One brings two, and he's missed again. Hit that very well, Matthew. Still in the match, got to almost prove to his opponent that he's still in there fighting. Joswell 3, Mark Selby 2 there on the other table, still in it, the world champion. Marking 2 and up on Peter Ebden. And the Pragnell Pinches match is not over yet, but it's getting close to being, because I think George Pragnell is going to beat Barry Pinches. 35 left and he's 48 in front. Could see a young player coming through. The winner plays again tonight against David Gilbert. So could be quite late, 15. That. Kick because he jumped up in the air and he leapt up in the air. George Pragnell has beaten Barry Pinches 4-3, that's confirmed. They didn't have much angle to play with there. played it well. He overhit that slightly, I thought. Didn't stroke it in like he can when he's right. Looks like Mark Selby's made the score 3-3 with Joe Swale. This match is, this frame is not over yet, although that's not the best of positions to be in. If he could knock the pink or black in, he would have a chance of dishing these up and winning by 4-1, but he's still, this is a difficult next colour. Might prefer to play the black, slightly wider pocket from there. Fine shot. That really is a good shot to get the red into play. And he's won a good positional shot from the possible clearance here, I think. I don't know whether he wants to just... looks like he's coming all around the table. He'll have to play this well. He has played it exceptionally well. It's a fine shot.
14.
He's not got a great angle on this black. But again, because of no angle, he had a difficult shot to get to anywhere near the yellow. So again, he's one shot away. He's kind of back to where he was in that regard. Bit of a stun run through, a bit of a Cliff Thorburn 147 shot he's got here. Played it well.
One.
Oh, this is exceptionally good stuff. He's just a tiny bit short of pace on this. He'd like to have been a ball's width further up, and I don't think he could have missed it, but there is just an outside chance now that he could. Is very good. I'm very impressed by this. Here's match ball. Oh, that's very good snooker. Very good stuff there from Mark Joyce, and it's a tremendous clearance, and all things considered, I thought he played a very fine match there. Anyway, he's won, and he's beaten Matthew Stevens 4-1, and he's back tomorrow now in the last 16. Well, it'll count. We can go into the bunch here with pace. He's got a new cue these days. He had his old cue stolen. And I don't know with his old cue, whether he'd have followed that or not, he probably would have. It's worked out badly for him. Yes, his cue was stolen over his car during the summer, earlier in the summer, and the same cue he's had for years. And it was never returned. So here he is using a different cue, which I think by now he must have halfway got used to. I asked him about it. He said he had got used to it. frame five. A very impressive display thus far from Mark Joyce. We missed that by a mile. Sometimes now, the way I see of Matthew here, I wonder if he is used to this cue. Some of the long pots, he's kind of pushing straight onto them. If he's not entirely happy. This is hit a little thin, and he's hit the yellow on the way back, which is done him a favour. It looks like it's covered. Not this time, though, I think there's a gap for Mark Joyce to get through. Too many people around this table at the moment. They might filter in. We've got matches going on elsewhere which are attracting interest. We missed that by a mile. Sometimes now, the way I see of Matthew here, I wonder if he is used to this cue. Some of the long pots, he's kind of pushing straight onto them. As if he's not entirely happy.
He's
still okay, he's a bit close to the cushion here. He knocks a lot of balls in, doesn't he?
Thank you.
46.
Well, it's been a fluent match so far, these two. We can go into the bunch here with pace. He's got a new cue these days. He had his old cue stolen. And I don't know with his old cue, whether he'd have followed that or not, he probably would have. It's worked out badly for him. Yes, his cue was stolen over his car during the summer, earlier in the summer, and the same cue he's had for years. And it never was never returned, so here he is using a different cue, which I think by now he must have halfway got used to. I asked him about it. He said he had got used to it. King has won the opening frame against Peter Ebden, I can tell you. It's okay, he's on one to the middle. Just hit the near jaw. 2011, beat him in 2010 and 2012. 9. See a couple of reds both pop there, as you could see.
14. 15.
going in the middle of the pocket, aren't they? He's looking good. Well, he just, to be honest, doesn't really look like missing, and I'll probably put the curse on him for saying that. Well, it'll count. We can go into the bunch here with pace. He's got a new cue these days. He had his old cue stolen. And I don't know with his old cue, whether he'd have pulled that or not, he probably would have. It's worked out badly for him. Yes, his cue was stolen out of his car during the summer, earlier in the summer, and the same cue he's had for years. and it never was never returned. So here he is. Mind he made a century in the previous frame. He's seeing the big
51.
Well, he's almost there. He's actually mathematically there with a snooker needed, but another red will absolutely win the frame. I'm not sure he wanted that because he can't take a high enough value colour with the red. And if he doesn't put a colour, I suspect he'll concede anyhow. Sure he wanted that because he can't take a high enough value colour with the red, and if he doesn't put a colour, I suspect he'll concede anyhow. Probably got to just knock the brown in and be done with it. Yeah, as I said, he would concede if he missed a colour, and that's it. It's 3-1 to Mark Joyce, and he's playing exceptionally well. He's barely missing a ball, and he needs one more frame, and he'll be back tomorrow. Yes, he's on 87, so that's going to be a 4-0 to Kyron. Mark was furious that not played that very well, but if the two Reds have lined themselves up for a plant, they'd be very lucky. I don't think they are lined up. Never going to get past those Reds there. He's let Joyce straight back in. And he leapt up in the air. George Pregnell has beaten Barry Pinches 4-3, that's confirmed.
Thirty-six.
How did that stay out? I'm surprised.
Six.
Seven. Well, this is a very bright start. He missed a red to the middle. The difference between the two was that he got a little bit lucky when he missed, and the red cleared away from the pocket. And of course, when Matthew did, he somehow it stuck over the middle. I don't quite know how it finished there. Well, he's almost there. He's actually mathematically there with a snooker needed, but another red will absolutely win the frame.
Choice 16.
I'm not sure he wanted that because he can't take a high enough value colour with the red. And if he doesn't put a colour, I suspect he'll concede anyhow. Probably got to just knock the brown in and be done with it. As I said, he would concede if he missed a colour, and that's it. 3-1 to Mark Joyce, and he's playing exceptionally well. He's barely missing a ball, and he needs one more frame, and he'll be back tomorrow. Eighty-nine, Mark Joyce, and a very thorough and emphatic victory in frame one against Matthew Stevens. He leads by a frame to nil. Well, it'll count. He's short on the blue. He has got that red with the black on, but it's from further away than he would have hoped.
17.
I'd be fuming. Got the wrong side of the blue, and he's further away from the red than he would have liked. That's basically what happened there. That's okay. Cue ball's lost slightly, but not so bad. That's what he tried. Now, very frustrating to go in behind that red. Squeezed in.